Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Vancouver Resource Investment Conference, and we are now at the booth of Orania Resources, and Dr. Keith Barron will give us an update onto his terrific company.
Keith, welcome. Here we are, Jochen, at another show.
Yeah, absolutely. Last time we saw us in Munich, right?
That's right,
yes. It was quite a good thing, but we crowded again here. I'm really astonished what's going on. Looks like resources are maybe in front of a little comeback.
I haven't seen a group like this for 7 years now.
Yeah.
And I really think things are rolling over. The money is coming out of the cryptos, out of cannabis, and it's coming back to where it should be.
To the resource.
In the resource sector. Fantastic, yeah. Fantastic.
That's
outcome.
Right.
So we're doing very, very well. Mm-hmm. We've been putting out a lot of press, and this year, 2019, you're going to see a lot of news from us. A lot of news flow because we've got a lot going on. Mm-hmm. So we've got about 100 people in the field right now.
Wow, that's a lot.
And yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Eight geologists, and we've made lots and lots of press releases lately. The latest one, we talked about some copper values that we had up to 9%.
Mm-hmm. And those were grab samples, right?
Grab samples, yes. So we haven't really got our heads around that environment yet, what's going on, but 9%, I mean, when you figure
out that the
average mine in the world right now mines 0.7%.
Yeah, yeah.
So this is more than an order of magnitude higher. This
That's
is wonderful.
Right, yeah.
So we just have to map out the extents of this, and it's a long time before we're going to drill that. So maybe later in this year, but our focus right now is on Crunchy Hill.
Yeah.
Now, we've talked about Crunchy Hill before.
Mm-hmm.
It's an epithermal gold-silver target. There's no gold on the surface, but we have what are called pathfinder elements in abundance. So things like arsenic, antimony, mercury, selenium, thallium. There's lots of silver as well.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're just about to drill that, imminently about to drill it. We're waiting for a piece of paper, which I think will come within the next couple of days.
Super. Mm-hmm. So that means that then afterwards you can really start to drill, everything is set up.
That's right.
Wow.
Well, we already have the drill on site.
Yeah.
The personnel are there. We're just waiting for the green light.
Wow, fantastic. And how long will it take then, and especially how many meters you think you are drilling, and how long will it take when you have the first results out?
Well, we would like to drill five holes.
Mm-hmm.
The deepest we would go would be maybe 350 meters, but I don't think we'll have to go that deep.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we're planning anyway and budgeting for. And that's what we're budgeting for, and I think at the end of the day, we should have the results, at least the preliminary results for the PDAC, the beginning of March. That's
nice.
Our goal.
Well, that's how fast it would be. Wow, that's fantastic.
Great.
Super. Maybe if we can go one thing back, 9% copper in a grab sample.
Yes.
Can you tell us how this works, how you come on such a percentage? How do you measure that?
Well, it's just essentially the geologist walking through the jungle, and they've come across this. But this is not just in one area. This is actually over an area which is now approaching 20 kilometers, stuff in excess of 1%. So this is very, very powerful. We don't know what it means.
Mm-hmm.
It's always in proximity to a porphyry-type target that we can see from the magnetics. So that's probably what's generating it. But you know, very, very interesting, because typically what happens, this is what's called secondary copper, supergene copper.
Mm-hmm.
So in this sort of a scenario, you'll have an upgrade, a natural upgrade from the porphyry, which may have 0.5%, at least 3 times, sometimes 5 times, 10 times higher.
Mm-hmm.
It's the sort of thing that they found early in the days in Escondida, which is the world's largest copper mine right now.
Mm-hmm.
It paid for all the infrastructure that was built.
Mm-hmm.
So we're very excited about it.
Super.
But besides that, we've got high-grade silver with lead zinc.
Sounds good.
And we've got now we've got 8 silver gold epithermal targets.
Mm-hmm. Okay, super. Then come back to the drilling.
Yes.
So there would be like the first drilling this year. Any other plans, let's say, for summer or for the fall then?
Well, I would just like to keep the drill there forever. It may never ever leave the property. That's the plan.
Until you sell it very expensively.
Exactly. Yes. And along those lines, you know, we have a very, very large property, and we're getting a lot of targets. The geologists are generating a lot of targets, and this gives us a lot of flexibility down the road for potential joint ventures, for potential sales of some sort of things.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to spend other people's money. rather than diluting down the shareholders all the time. So, you know, I think we're getting close to that point where we're going to have to make some critical decisions for the company. Mm-hmm. But of course, myself and the board of directors, we want to get the best deal for the shareholders.
Super.
Since I own 51% of the company, it's going to be the best deal for me as well.
You're the captain in our boat.
Absolutely, I am.
I'm a shareholder too.
Yes.
No, fantastic, great. Mm-hmm. So I would say at PDAC, let's do then the next update, because then we have drill results.
Yes, we'll have preliminary.
Or anything else you want to add?
No, just keep your fingers crossed and watch the news flow this year.
Okay, I put it in my nightly pray before I go to bed.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Keith, thank you very much.
Okay.
And really keep it going, keep the drills turning, and I want to see the results before PDSC.
Great.
And then we see us. Super. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, it was a short update from Dr. Keith Barron, the CEO of Oranja Resources. And you heard it, the drills will start soon to turn, and that's exactly what we have waited for, because grab samples like with 9% copper, super high values of silver. They have zinc, they have lead inside. It is amazing what they have found so far. And as we always know, where smoke is, there is fire. And that is exactly what this property shows like. And I mean, Keith has done it in the past, so I'm quite confident he does it again. So thanks for watching us. Check out the company. Bye-bye from Vancouver.
Bye-bye.